Yeah, it was almost like watching the show Lost. Like, what the fuck is this about? That was how... Like, I've never said this about a pussy. Her pussy was manic. I don't even know what that means. And hey, sometimes she would come over. I like when she would call ahead. Let me know she's coming over. Because sometimes she'd pop in last minute, and she'd jump on my bed naked. And I didn't like that, because sometimes she'd be, you know, leaking residue and shit. So. Yeah, and I've got a pretty nice thread count. I'm doing okay, you know? If she calls ahead, I'll throw the free POs on there, you know? It's over. And we're laying in bed, and this is what happened. She opens up her legs, and she turns to me, and she goes, hey, take your fat fucking cock and stick it in my juicy pussy, and fuck the shit out of my juicy pussy with your fat cock and fucking balls. I'm paraphrasing. It's not a, don't Mark Twain that. It's a. So I say to her, I go, listen, we can't do that tonight because I don't have any condoms. So she retorts with, I don't give a shit, stick it in raw dog. Yeah, she knew the term raw dog. No girl should know the term raw dog. Let alone use it in a phrase. Hi, I'm a red flag. Nice to meet you. Raw dog? No. Even girls sitting here tonight should be like, what, is that a hot dog that wasn't cooked properly? Yes. Yeah. Yes, that's exactly what it is, classy ladies. That's what you should know. Sticking in raw dog. So I say back to her, I said, listen, I go, let me reiterate. I can't, I don't have any condoms. I don't have any tall kitchen bags. I don't have a laminating machine. Or magic. No. Please. She shoots back with, well, Dane, I want to get off. Stick something in me.
Oh, God.
And here's the thing, you guys. I don't have toys. I don't have, like, vibrators and dildos. All that stuff's in storage. I'm moving. So to please her, finally, this is what I did. I took my TV remote. And I'm not going to lie to you, I was a little more concerned about the remote. Let me explain. It was a universal remote, and I was afraid of the sticky factor with the buttons. Also, the battery hatch was loose. I was afraid the Duracells were going to fall out in there, and I'm going to have to fish them out. I'm not going up there. Do some jumping jacks. I'm sure gravity will take over. I'm sure your vagina doesn't take double A's. I know what you're saying right now. You're saying, hey, excuse me, why the fuck would you tell this to us? This story is wrong, as the gays would say, on so many levels. But I tell this story because there's actually some good news to be had. I wouldn't bring you on this little adventure only to leave you in the middle of nowhere. No, there's some good news. But let's recap. The cons, the negatives.
Oh, no.
I stuck the remote control in this girl's vagina. Hey, I did this. Here's the good news, the silver lining, the upshot. She TiVo'd the departed.
Oh my God.
And I did see that video. I know some people have been sending me the link to the, I was on MySpace the other. By the way, I'm on MySpace. I don't do Facebook. You know, I don't like it. I don't get it. The other day I logged into my Facebook, I got poked by a fucking zombie. I didn't even. And then he bought me a cocktail and planted a tree in my honor. What? I don't like this shit. I need some fucking undead barkeep serving me mixed drinks, getting all botanical on me. But somebody did send me the link of the Britney Spears dancing the other day, and her tampon is halfway out. Did you see that? Yeah, she's dancing, and I'll say that the tampon's doing like the choreography with her and stuff.
Oh, God!
And I was shocked by this when I saw that. I was actually shocked because I was like, I didn't know her vagina could hold anything in anymore. I would have been more shocked if the rear left quarter panel of a 72 GTO popped out of that side. Ooh! Can I just say something? something about her vagina. Have you ever seen it up close when she's getting out of a car or something? Her vagina looks like a stroke victim's mouth. No vagina should disappear around the bend. I was masturbating violently. I wanted to tell you guys about this. Speaking of vaginas. I'm only a man. Guys, we like to do this, you know. There's a lot of euphemisms that guys use when we're playing with it, right? Playing with ourselves, and we're choking the chicken, and you know, jerking off. And, you know, but girls don't really have, like, what do you think, like, girls, what do you call it? Like, fiddling the bean? We call it jacking off. You call it, like, chilling off or something? Hold a bucket in your hand, run up a hill. Something really, I'm gonna share with you something that happened when I was pleasuring myself recently. No, this is actually fucking scary, what I'm about to tell you. I had a frightening experience during one of my sessions, as I call it. I made an appointment with myself. Okay, here's what happened. So I'm pretty comfortable. I'm laying in my bed, and I've got, I'm all set up. I got three pillows behind my back. Yeah, I like three pillows. I like a nice hospital bed setting when I'm about to. I tried two pillows. It feels like I'm falling off a cliff. I don't like that sensation. I tried one pillow. I feel like I'm jerking off in my own casket, which is just makes me feel. I got three pillows. I've got a little bowl of Reese's Pieces that I keep next to me. You know, in case I get famished, I do 10 or 20 little jags and I go. What happened next was, so I'm going along, everything's going very well. When I finally ejaculated, I've never had so much exit. I was fucking scared. I'm not even kidding. So much came out that I actually turned my penis away from myself, and I heard myself go, whoa! I said, whoa, like it was a runaway steed. Whoa! And it wouldn't stop. It was like, bah, 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 bah. It was like the finale of a fireworks display. That's a lot of smoke. Roughly the same amount. Like normally I can fill up my belly button. I know this. Aww. I just aim it down, a little spillage, you know. Kennedy half dollar size, that's me.
Oh, God.
But on this day, blah, 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 I can't describe it to you in terms of measurement, but I will say this. If I was at Cold Stone, it was a gotta have it size. Enjoy your Cold Stone. Gosh, I used to really like Cold Stone. I used to go in there all the time when I wanted to get myself a little sweet treat, you know? They used to be so friendly. Remember a few years ago how friendly they were? They were so excited for your business as they were coming up the ranks. You'd walk in the front door, little bell would go off, ding, ding, ding. You know, employee would lean out of the back room. Just give me 33 seconds. I'm just washing up. Thank you, no problem. I'm just going to peruse the mixins. Right? And even that was like a delightful experience because there was 10 options. You walk in there now, there's so many options. You walk in, the guy's like, come on, there's more on the roof. Follow me. Follow me down this fireman's pole. There's some in the basement. Right? You know what to mix? Yeah, I'll take some Heath and some, what is that, fucking fish hooks? I don't know. Some light bulb shards and my grandmother's eyes. All right. Yes, waffle ball, please. Thank you. A couple of years ago, when you would put a little tip in the tip jar, what they do, they'd sing you a little song. And they were so excited to do it, right? You put a tip in there, they'd say, staff, gather around, we just got a tip. The whole staff would be like, really? And they'd stand, harmonize, and sing a little song. Lick, lick, lick the night away. And you'd leave it out. You ever put a tip in the tip jar recently? No song should start off like this. Fucking A. I'm sorry, I don't think the Four Tops sang fucking A.